Good evening all. Today I'm going to present a e-poster on title Role of DNA in Gender Identification, and it is an informative poster. Introduction: Identification of an individual is very important in forensic casework, and various methods are used in forensic odontology in both gender and personal identification. The identification is used by either nuclear DNA or by mitochondrial DNA. First picture shows the sources of DNA. Sources of DNA, there are innumerable number of biological material can be used as a source for DNA, which includes hair, tooth, blood, and urine and bone, etc. And this third image shows the DNA in dental identification. Teeth represent the excellent source of DNA material due to its resistant nature to incineration, immersion, trauma, and other types of environmental assault. And this teeth represent an excellent source of nuclear DNA. Even a root canal filled tooth can be used as a sufficient for the biological material for PCR analysis. And the method used for DNA identification is cryogenic grinding method. And the second image shows the steps in DNA identification. There are 7 steps in DNA identification. First is collection and storage of DNA. And second is extracting the DNA. And third step is quantifying the DNA. Fourth is amplifying the genetic loci to be examined. Fifth step is analyzing the amplified DNA using the gel electrophoresis method. Sixth step is DNA profiling, and seventh step is presenting the data to the context of the other evidence. And now there are many genes which is used in gender identification. First is amyl gene. Amyl is nothing but it's one of the major protein secreted by ameloblast of enamel. In amyl gene, if the gender is female, it indicates it have 2 identical amyl gene. In case of male, it have 2 different amyl gene. Female, it shows 2 identical. In male, it shows 2 different amyl gene. And next is SRY gene. SRY gene is a sex determination gene on Y chromosome, and it is a SRY gene is unique for Y chromosome. DNA binding activity is vital for testis formation. So SRY gene indicates the gender male. Next is zinc finger gene. It is present in both X and Y chromosome. Whenever it is subjected to the digestion by restrictive enzyme, this X chromosome will yield 2 fragments, whereas the Y chromosome will yield three fragments. Next is STR gene. STR gene is short tandem repeat Y gene, and it is very specific for Y chromosome. This STR gene is passed directly from father to son, so it is present in male. Next is STS. STS is nothing but a steroid sulfatase gene, and it is a protein coding gene that it is involved in steroid metabolism, and it's specifically located in X chromosome, that is in female. Next is HLA-DRB1. And it belongs to the HLA class 2 beta chain, and it is present in both X and Y chromosome. Application of DNA in forensic odontology, that is the merits, includes: it is widely accepted as a standard forensic technique for investigation and detection of crime due to its specificity, and PCR technique has made the DNA even more popular. Demerits are: it is not always possible to recover the DNA from bite mark due to the reason of contamination, degradation, and putrefaction. And it is also time-consuming, technique-sensitive, and expensive. Here, I'm concluding by saying the arrival of DNA has transformed the concept of identification of gender, and clinical observation of available medical and dental patients' record remains the gold standard for forensic odontology. This is my references. Thank you.